25 minutes for me to tell you everything that the Lord has told me. First thing he told me this morning was, open up your heart, baby. So I'm asking each and every single one of you, open up your heart. Open up your heart and open up your ears. Pay attention to the Lord's word, because it's for you. He's already given it to me. So I've gained my strength, and I've gained my encouragement, and now I'm gonna give it to you. It's a brand new year. Brand new season. Brand new season. Yesterday, the Lord said, I wait for you every day, you wait on me. She preached about, awake from your slumber. People walk around like they sleep. I told Apostle Lisa, as we were watching TV yesterday, and they had the New Year's Eve parade. They had all of these different floats, and the Star Wars, and the little kids jumping on the side, and everybody had a little confetti coming out, and everybody was seemingly happy. And I said, you know, that's a shame. I said, you know why they're celebrating? I said, they're celebrating because they're happy that they made it to another year. But yet, they do not celebrate God, the God who caused them to live another day. And I say, it's a shame that they don't understand that God said, I know my plans for you is disaster, because you have forsaken me. So I say, these fools are in a fairy tale. They're yee. And I said, you have no clue that God is against you. You'll sit there and you'll say prayers, and you'll say things when things go on that's wrong, and you'll say, we'll hold this vigil, because this person died that we loved, or how could this person get shot, or this person got burned in the fire. And they say, well, we asked everybody to give their prayers. And I say, you will ask every heathen and pagan out there that does not know God to pray to a God that they do not serve. And God said, why pray to me when you know me not? So they live in a fairy tale. Now, if they heard me talking, and when they see me, they say, he living in a fairy tale. And I say, you know what? They told Noah the same thing. And for 127 years, he kept trying to make everybody repent and know that God was against them. He said, because he's about to flood this whole earth. And they said, we've never seen water before. How can that be? But I guarantee you, when God brought that flood upon the earth, everybody was scratching and clawing to get into that ship that Noah had built, because they did not want to die. They knew not what was coming for them. So I say, open up your heart today. Amen?
Amen.
You were called to freedom.
Amen.
Only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for the flesh, but through love, serve one another. And then you know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Be careful, however, that the exercise of your freedom does not cause a stumbling block to those of a weaker conscience. For if someone sees you with your superior knowledge reclining in the house of a false god, will not their weak consciences be encouraged to do those things which are offered up as hypocrites also? Hear me as I speak God's word. You can live as free people, but do not use your freedom as an excuse to do evil. For such is the will of God, that by doing right, you may silence the ignorance of foolish men. And in this truth do I speak. For it is not the hearers of the word who are righteous before God, but it is those who obey the word who will be declared righteous. For the wicked are overthrown and are no more. And when the storms of life come, the wicked are whirled away, but the godly have a lasting foundation. Therefore, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken them to a wise person which built their house upon a rock. For God will not fail, nor be discouraged, till he establishes justice on earth. You have all been called to freedom. But lose the hard head and the indecisive heart. But now that you have come to know God, or should I say, now that God knows you, how can you turn back against to the weak and worthless spiritual principles of this world and be enslaved by them all over again? I hope this doesn't offend anyone. For when you were in deep water, did the flood overwhelm you that you could not stand on solid ground? And by the Lord's will, were you not led like running horses on flat land flowing in both hills and valleys and did not stumble? You see, in the beginning there was darkness and you could not know. But to the very least of all the saints, this grace was given. Now be not stubborn to understand the light, which is Christ Jesus, who unveiled God's plan that we should not all fall again. Do not stumble because of your heart, and do not die because of your ways. Let it be that you would understand my words, that God would accept your offerings and your sacrifices be declared as righteous. For the scepter will not depart from Jesus, nor the ruler's staff from between his feet, until he to whom it belongs shall come, and the obedience of people shall be his. You have your freedom, but let it not be in vain. For if you wait for daylight and not see the first rays of dawn, do you not hope for light and never see it? For in this way, the disobedient come with their clever plans and selfish plots, the schemes of their own heart. It is a way used by many, a destructive way that leads to an end without meaning, an end without God. You have your freedom, but let it not be at your own expense. Rather, let it be God's will that's done so that you may have eternal life. For who of us can create life that lasts? And who of us has lived a perfect life that we did not need God? Let us take a breath. Let us start to think clearer and more responsibly. That is, if we are to say that we are servants of the Lord. For God does not take a liar lightly, and he does not welcome a hypocrite with open arms. We all have freedom. But what liberty do we choose? In a country where a statue and a flame stands atop the waters, welcoming all who would come and join and lead with the world. A land where justice is injustice, and honor is amongst thieves. And there are none who are righteous, just religious, and religion is their key to salvation, but not God. And we are all bound to make a choice. Some choose life, some choose death, neither knowing which is which, till God has come to judge them. Therefore, be sure, be content, and pleasing to God, that you may be called worthy when the end comes. You have your freedom. However, at that time when you did not know God, you were a slave to those things which by nature are not God's. Remember that. Your freedom is precious, more precious than rubies, for nothing you can desire will compare to God. For the Lord makes the people more scarcer than pure gold and mankind rather than the golden stones and precious onyx. You have your freedom. Only do not do as you want, but do as the Lord would have you to do, that you may be blessed in all things. But Jesus said, see, you are well again. Therefore, stop sinning or something worse may happen to you. Now go and leave your life of sin behind. I say, be free, but do not lose your spiritual freedom to the flesh. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them turn to the Lord, and he will have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will freely forgive them. We all have been called to freedom, but only a few remain, and all others have strayed and become distracted by the lure of things that led to death. I say unto the unbelievers, do you not know that the Lord has prepared a disaster for you and devised a plan against you? So turn from your evil ways and change your ways and your actions. For you have freedom, but it is only in God. And if not God, then but what liberty do you speak, and by what authority was given to you to be blessed? As for everyone who comes to me and hears my word, the wise take oil and jars along with their lamps. For we have all been called to freedom. But the righteous walk with the wise to become wiser, and those who associate with fools only get in more trouble. Therefore, we should trust God and be content with all that he has given us in life, that we do not stray because of want. Instead, we should wait on the Lord, for he will answer us. Do you really want God? Then act like it. Do you really say that you love God? Then prove yourself. But if you can't stay in his will for the long haul, and you just give up and quit, just know that his son died on the cross so that you and I could have undying mercy and unfailing love no matter who we are. Yes, you can have your freedom. And not just another day, but a brand new year and a whole new season that you can change how you are and who you were, and by the grace of God, become a better person. And not just a made-up image or a cleverly devised shadow for everyone to see, but a real you, pure and righteous, blessed and favored, matured by the one and only true living God of the Most High. I tell you, you can have your freedom. But don't you let the favor of the Lord pass you by because you thought it not important enough that he was God. And don't you let the cares of this world wrap you up and sweep you away that you would drown in your own cesspool of lies and die as all the others who have forsaken the Lord, only to find that death was their final reward. You know, I say to you, be free, but be mindful that you did not create yourself. And if you had known God, then you would know that whatever good he has brought into your life, it was not by you, but by him. And know that. You did not make it this far according to your own will, but by him all things are, and without him they could not be. I will say again, you have your freedom. But what good is liberty when the price you pay is your life? And what good is a life taken if it has no worth and has accrued no interest? For whoever has, to them more shall be given, and they will have it in abundance. But for those who are not paying attention, even what little they do have, it will be taken away from them. Mm-hmm. And I do not deny that we have all been called to be free. But if you believe that God is a fool or unwise to your active excuses on why you could not remain faithful, be that as it may, you will sorely regret being stubborn, and you will surely be painfully reminded come judgment day. You have the freedom. But only the Lord knows whether you choose to do what is right in his sight. And we can all make excuses about what we want for ourselves and what we want for others around us. But come judgment day, all bets are off. I say to you, now's the time. This is the year. What are you waiting for? Is not the Lord to return soon? Is not God looking down on each one of us and eyeing every word we speak and every action that we take? And who are we to fool God? Who are we to say that it will be okay, but yet do how we please, when we please, according to how we feel like doing and how we feel like being to others? Amen. If you ask me, that is the plan of a fool. And trust me when I say, I have been the fool, so I know what the experience is. And that plan has been overthrown by the Most High Lord God, who lives forever and ever and shall not fail. No, not one, and not even I will be left behind because God has freed me. Amen. Now my question to all of you is, do you want to be free?
Amen.
Do you want to be free? For if so, or if you already are free, I pray this prayer. And I ask that everyone bow their heads. In the greatness of his name and peace, whose mercy never ends, wash away, and cleanse us from our sin. Create anew a waiting heart, whose soul cries out to thee. My Lord of Lords, King of Kings, our joyful portion be. And where we rove, the rivers flow, O Lord, surround us still. Bless the Father, bless the Son, as we ascend thy hill. The very flesh has restless fits, our changing limbs conspire with all these troubles of the mind, our inner self to tire. O gracious God, in whom we live, our feeble efforts aid. Help us watch to pray and strive, though trembling and afraid. Increase our faith, increase our hope when foes and fears prevail, and lift our fainting spirit up, forgiving those who fail. Oh, keep us in the righteous way and bid the tempter flee, and let us never, never stray from happiness in thee. We thank you, dear Father, and we believe that Jesus died for our sins. We ask that you come into our hearts, dear Lord, and bless us that we may sin no more. We thank you, Father, and we repent of our ways that you may be pleased and that you may favor us and give us blessings. May we become forever humble in your presence, and may your ways be set within our hearts. We ask that you would pour your mighty spirit upon us to lead us, guide us, and heal us in goodness and perfection. Keep us, dear Lord, keep us, for we believe that you will never let us go. In the name of God, the Son, and the Spirit of the Most High, we all pray in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Now breathe, for every single one of you have been given freedom. Amen.
Amen.
A new year.
Yes.
How much longer do we have?
That's all I can say. If anybody in this room knows how long they have, and I say, you don't even need to hear a word I got to say. But if you don't know how long you got left here on this planet, whether the Lord come back or whether he take you first, I say, it's time to change whatever you haven't changed that ain't right with the Lord. I can't tell you what ain't right. I don't know you that well, and I wouldn't tell you anyhow because I'm not here to judge anybody. I can't even judge myself. All I can do is do what the Lord would tell me to do so that I can do what's right by him. That's all I can do. Now, if I have somebody around me, I have my family around me, they'll tell you. If anybody in this whole place, they'll tell you. When it comes to him, he going to tell you what the Lord going to tell him. Because the Lord stay on me constantly. He don't give me no room to breathe. And I don't need no room to breathe. I ain't nothing but a fool and a stubborn maniac who's opinionated. I have nothing in me that I can give that's good. So he don't give me no room to breathe. But I tell each and every one of you, if you fear for your life, what life you do have left, if you fear to not be blessed by God and protected by God, because it does you no good to drop down on your hands and knees, and I don't care how many tears you have, I don't care how big your heart is, I don't care how hard you can scream and whose shoulder you can lean on. I can tell you this, it makes no sense to do none of that if you don't do what God's telling you to do. You're just a fool. That's all it is. I'll tell each and every single one of you, don't you dare ever sit there and be a hypocrite or play like you got God, and then when you call on God, wonder why he ain't answering you. You should already know the answer. He does not play. He says, you will fear me, and you will humble yourself. I'm telling you. I'm telling you by who stands in front of me. I'm telling you. He does not play with us. And he say, if you're going to love me, obey me. That's point blank. But don't go calling on him when you don't have it, unless you repent. But repent means to change. It doesn't mean to forgive you and then you continue to be who you are. He say, I want you to change. See, he ain't no fool, I say again. He's not a man. He's not one of us. We got the cleverest minds in the world to sit there and fool one another and play games with one another and give excuses to one another. But God don't want to hear none of that. He's not that type of God. He say, you better get out and respect who I am and honor. He said, I'm an amazing God. And I fear him. He caught me with fear. Some people, he caught with a different way. And they'll preach a different thing. But I'm telling you, when it come to me, he caught me with fear. He showed me things that I don't even want to see. I say, my God, please just take this off of me. I'll do whatever you want me to do. But I'm not going to play with you because I see you not playing with me. And for some reason, you'll take me more serious than you'll take other people because you'll put things on me that I don't see you putting on no one else. But he say, that's because I want you to pay attention. Ourselves. Humbling means open up your heart. Take that callous piece off. You see? He's giving you sight. And he wants us to make it. We ain't got no other choice. You either make it or you don't. Let's do something new this season. We don't know when he's going to return, but it's going to be soon. And even if it ain't soon for him to return, he may put us to sleep. Either way, let's get it right. Let's get it right. Bless the Lord. Thank you all each for coming. Thank you for hearing his word. And I pray that the Lord leads you and guides you. And I pray that he blesses you. And I pray whatever prayers that you have had out there, that he would answer them. And I'm pretty sure he will. Amen.
Amen. Amen.